Hello, hello. Hey, what's up, Ray? How are you doing? Does everything sound okay? How are you doing? Welcome, welcome back. Kevin, you got some cool emotes, by the way. I noticed you often use the cat sipping boba. And then I see you have a cat here with the raining heart. Is it raining hearts? Are these your own personal emotes or are they from a different channel that you follow? Okay, very cool. Taking mental notes, I gotta figure out my own emotes. There we go. There it is. Cat sipping. Is it the Sailor Moon cat? It kind of looks like, because it has the moon crest on its forehead. I mean, it also could just be like a, you know, cool symbol. But, it's like, what, is it not? Does Sailor Moon kind of have a moon on its forehead, actually? I don't remember. I don't know. Oh, that's the actual, the VTuber you follow? Is, like a moon cat? It's cute though. Is it sipping boba or is it sipping soda? What's nice. Knowing VTubers and general VTuber culture, I would assume it's boba. Not to stereotype or anything, but you know, it's a pretty strong chance. I'm guessing that they're not part of like Hololive though. I don't recall anybody from Hololive or like Vishojo having a moon cat as their sort of avatar. Is this like an independent streamer? Hey, Selena and Breeze. Hey, hello, hello. Welcome back, both of you. It's good to see all of you again. It really is. I missed you guys on Monday. Ah, there. Okay, so that cat that you follow, VTuber, is 14 and WoW streamer, MMO people. Very cool. Anybody else follow VTubers and streamers in here? I mean, I guess obviously you follow streamers since you're literally here with me right now. But do you guys also follow VTubers and stuff? For the folks who are just joining right now, Selena and Vries. Obviously, Vries is a VTuber. In case anybody here was not aware, Vries Kamoa here recently just had his 3D avatar debut on his channel. Vries, you've been streaming. I think you've been streaming for a little while as a 2D, maybe like a PNG tuber. And then, but then you recently now have, you know, your live 2D, not 3D, I mean, yeah, live 2D, I believe. So congrats to to Vreeze. If you guys are interested in VTubers, check give him a follow. He does 14 gaming as well. And then I saw the other day he's been doing like housing streaming as well. So if you want a secondary housing stream, give Vreeze a look. I was talking to Kevin Arima here in the chat a little bit before we went live, or right as we went live. I went live a little early today. And I'm sure you guys probably have seen his little like Boba Cat emote, the one that he uses. I think I said Simp Sip. Nice. Simply Two. There you go. It's like a little moon cat that's like a little black cat with a moon symbol and a sipping boba. Kevin, if you want to throw that back in the chat again so people can see what I'm talking about. I'm sure you guys have seen Kevin Arima use this. And I was asking where it's from, and he was saying, oh, it's a VTuber that he follows who streams 14 and WoW. So, hey, Alara, what's up? What's up? How are you doing, Alara? How's your new TV been working out for the last week or so? Is it all holding up okay? Also, oh yeah, Kevin, Crony's great. I follow Crony as well. She's quite a character. I actually like, I started looking, I got introduced to the idea of VTubers, you know, during COVID. And a friend showed me like Iron Mouse and Coco and Gura. But then I kind of like really looked into VTuber stuff like right as Whole Alive Council debuted. And actually that is really what kind of hooked me in. Cause I think jumping into some of the existing fandoms like Iron Mouse or Coco or something, it was like a little bit like a lot, you know, because they're so established, there's like so much going on already. So it was kind of cool that like I happened to be exploring VTuber like right as Hololive Council went live. So then I felt like I kind of got eased into it, where like everybody was discovering those new people at the same time as I was, and that helped a bit. Hey, what's up, Party Jesus? Welcome to the stream. Thank you for blessing us with your presence. Jesus in the house, everybody. By the way, how's my stream looking? Is this smoother than before? I know it's not buttery smooth 60 frames per second and everything, but if you guys were on the last stream that I had, it was very choppy, especially near the end there, like unwatchably choppy. And so while it meant that I had to kind of side table some of the other updates and things I had planned for this last week, I spent a whole bunch of time troubleshooting this with Ray, who is also here in the chat, TFK, and some other friends, just trying to figure this out. And so trying to get this to be much more watchable and stable. So hopefully this is a lot easier on the eyes this time around. Oh, good. Well, I'm glad to hear that, Ray and Jesus and Amphi and everybody. Yeah, awesome. Thankfully, my mic, like if there's one thing, I know that I was told when I was first starting, like if there's something you need to get right, it's the audio, you know? Cause like you can kind of forgive bad visuals a little bit, right? Like especially because a lot of people like maybe watch especially this housing stream or even my DJ streams, right? It might be more of like a podcast, like radio for them, right? Like not everybody, most people don't probably watch streamers and like constantly have their eyes fixed to the screen, right? But then but you are probably listening, and so if the audio is mega scuffed, that'd be a big bummer. And Alara, I see, yeah, good. Yeah, wait, okay, see, Alara says it too. Like, that's Luna from Sailor Moon, though, isn't it? Right, that's what I thought too. I was like, wait, black cat symbol, like moon symbol on its forehead. That sounds like Sailor Moon or something, right? Which, like, I would not be surprised if that was the inspiration for the VTuber that Kevin follows that has that black moon cat. I mean, obviously, like, Sailor Moon is, like, one of those, like, OG kind of, you know, classic shows, so I'm sure it has inspired many a person who has now grown up and become a VTuber. Awesome. Okay. I'm so glad to hear Mike video. Listen to the background a second. Yeah, exactly, Vreeze. Mike and audio, music and everything, definitely more important than the actual video quality itself. Yeah. And Selena, are you doing you're like crafting like a billion cookies or something, right? That's what you mentioned to me last night. You said something about like that you had like a big crafting project or something going on. What was that? What exactly were you doing? I think that's what you mean, right? By 124 more items, just something crafting you're doing, right? Oh, okay. You mentioned the coffee biscuits. Are those still good money? I thought they were nerfing that a lot. Is that still a viable way to have burn up your leaves? Using the coffee biscuits? Okay, so it's nerfed, but it's nerfed, but is it still very much viable? Like, is there any Endwalker equivalent of that that's better in terms of burning up leaves if you just have like 100 sitting around? Okay, yeah, so there we go. Kevin, which leaves are those, Kevin, if you know? I'm sure people in the chat might find this useful, such as myself, asking for a friend. Also, I did this last time too, and it was great. Like, if anybody wants to come hang out while I'm not really so much building today, as we're just gonna be looking at the 6.1 housing items, all the new stuff that they added. So we will look at stuff here and then maybe pop into the garden as well, because there's a bunch of garden items. But yeah, if anybody wants to just like come hang out, come hang out with me. In fact, you know what? I think maybe we should start with the guard items since those are faster, or like there's like fewer of them. So let's go quickly over back to my... I'm going to be at my FC house. So if you want to come hang out, here's the address. If you guys are in game, I know that everybody's probably like a lot of you guys are doing 6.1 stuff right now. Totally understandable. And in which case, I wish you good luck on your hunts and on your alliance raid and PvP. That blanket statement, I also want to hear like some of your guys' thoughts and stuff. But if you are not busy and want to just come hang out in the what looks like the rain, if you kind of want to come and hang out in the rain with me here, you guys are more than welcome to. And then I'll bring some stools and stuff, and we can set it up in my little apartment where we're going to look at the rest of the housing items. So anytime during the stream today, if you want to come join or you have friends who want to come hang out, let's hang out together. And yeah, okay, so let's see. Kevin was saying, not as much. Oh, turning through. Okay, craftsman's pots and some culinary food. Not as much as the coffee biscuits, though. Honestly, the coffee biscuits thing was pretty nuts. It was very tedious and repetitive, but it was pretty awesome that you could do it. And yeah, that's true. Like, I mean, the nice thing about macro crafting and everything is, right, it's just one or two buttons, maybe three, and then you're just done. very, I can watch Netflix and just kind of like autopilot it kind of thing. Or you can watch your favorite housing streamers. By the way, wait, I saw earlier Alora say you didn't know what VTubering, like what a VTuber was. Is that, was it a joke or was that like, do you actually, are not quite sure what VTubering is? Because if it is, I'm happy to explain. I feel like that term, I mean, that will probably come up more and more on the stream, so I'd wanna let you know if you don't. No shame in it too. I mean, like, honestly, I didn't know until like a year ago. And then I got like crash coursed in it because I have some friends who are very into it, who kind of helped like show me what it was and stuff. Wish you could turn in items in bulk. Doing it, yeah, that is true. I do wish we could like mass turn in leaves. That would have been very good for not getting carpal tunnel and that kind of thing. There's a couple things, right? Like in game where like it's a little tedious. Partially because I don't think they ever really intended for you to turn in like 100 of anything at one time. But yeah, that would be a nice quality of life thing. If you could just say, if I have 10, you know, 900 cookies in my inventory, I would like to, whatever, you know, turn in this many leaves worth of them all at once. Which is like how you would do it in real life too, right? Like, I mean, if you showed up somewhere for like a food bank, you wouldn't like turn in every can separately. You would just be like, I have this bag, this like crate of cans. Please take them. Oh, okay. Okay, first of all, Ishgard plot from Vries here, asking if I'm gonna go for an Ishgard plot. The short answer is no, at least for me. But I am curious if any of you guys in the chat are like seriously going into the lottery and everything. I'm not gonna go for an Ishgard plot, probably not. Like, possibly down the road, I could try for like maybe upgrading this to a large or something. But I'm not sure that I want Ishgard personally. The thing is, like, for me, I'm not too big a fan of the cold. And so, like, I feel much more at home in greenery and stuff. So lav beds is actually one of the perfect spots for me. Like, this is my kind of vibe. So, like, no ding on people who like the cold in Ishgard, but just if I was going to, like, lotto into a larger house or something, I would probably want it to be somewhere that's more green and, like, yeah. Too cold. Yeah. See, so sounds like Selena's in the same thing as me of like that on a vibe level. Ishgard is maybe not quite our vibe, but like I totally get if you are about that, like, you know, like especially people who like that, just like that medieval fantasy look. Ishgard's perfect, right? I know like Ray, you know, is a big fan of the Ishgard vibe, just the stone and the cold and the snow and everything. I think it's awesome. I think like that's definitely a biome that we don't have right now in housing, right? You have to recreate it artificially in your garden with little snow plots and stuff. So to be able to just naturally fit in that vibe, I think is really cool for people who like that. Thanks for hot chocolate. That is true, yeah. Like, I would consider potentially, I had an idea for, or not, I have a idea for a build that I think would fit very well in an apartment in Ishgard. So there's a chance that I might take one of my alts and get an apartment or something in Ishgard and then use that for an apartment build. Cause yeah, like I definitely think that there's a lot of cool things that you can do with the idea of like snow, like cabins and, you know, again, the medieval look, taverns, guild halls, castles, dungeons, you know, these kinds of things. One Ishgard Lodge. Oh yeah, and okay, so Morgan, you're going for Ishgard Lodge. That mean, yeah, I could see it. I could see it. Morgan, do you, have you been experimenting with like, what do you call it? Like, I guess medieval stonework and stuff? Because I know a lot of your stuff, like your specialty seem to be modern wood, you know, like wood kind of stuff. Like, would you try to trying to integrate your modern, clean, you know, Scandinavian kind of look into the Ishgard look? Or are you interested in Ishgard because you want to like try something different? Amphi, by the way, are you feeling better? I know you said you had quite a bit of a headache yesterday. By the way, everybody, it was Amphi's birthday yesterday, so wish Amphi a happy belated birthday. Now that you mention it, one of the taverns. Yeah, more. I would love to see one of the taverns and one of, kind of related to what you were saying, but I've been really thinking about doing something Skyrim. Ooh, yeah. Okay, so more gone, you're going to try for something Skyrim inspired. Yeah, I think, like, I mean, Ishgard is super duper perfect for that, right? A tavern or an inn room. Yeah, love it. I can't wait to see what you come up with. That sounds so awesome. Cozy. Also, I saw Vries was saying, it may not be green, but it can fit in with the cozy cottagecore vibe. I'm curious. So, cottagecore. What defines cottagecore? You know, like I've heard the term and I kind of understand the vibe. Like it seems like it's very like artfully messy in a way. You know what I mean? Like in that kind of like, it's not quite grandma's house, but it's kind of like, you know, like if there was, what is it? I don't know, like some cottage in the woods and it was dressed up though by Miyazaki, right? Like if it was in a Ghibli film and you had a cottage in the woods, right? It'd be like, kind of like, it wouldn't be super pristine. It'd be kind of messy a little bit, but then it would be like artfully, beautifully, cozily messy. Is that cottagecore? That's okay, I need to start viewing a few of these items, but so like, okay, this gigantic, oh man, this is so cool. The detail on this thing is really good too. I really like this. Man, maybe we should just have, we need like two chats. We need like a just chatting chat, and then, or just chatting stream rather, two streams, and then like a review stream. It's just so much to talk about, guys. And like, we couldn't talk on Monday too. Just, Yeah, man. Ghibli sort of vibes want to fear. But but yeah, oh wait, okay, so sorry, wait, before I get, okay, very sidetracked, but, really quickly to address what I asked earlier, so, Alora said she was not aware of what a VTuber was. If you want, like, a really quick answer, you can look at Vreeze's channel, because he is a VTuber, and he just debuted his live 2D model, as well as you can look up people like, if you look up Hololive, they're like probably like the biggest, most like, I guess like produced group in terms of VTubering. Let's see, how do you TLDR this? Basically, it's the idea, VTuber, virtual YouTuber, or virtual, streamer basically. The idea is it's a person who uses a virtual avatar in place of themselves to do their streaming. Like in Vreeze's case, he's kind of similar to me where like he plays a Viera in the game, but he also like, you can't see me, but for Vreeze, he has like a model rigged up that tracks his movements, and then he streams and presents himself as that person, which is a representative of his character in the game in his case. But a lot of people who maybe don't have like Final Fantasy characters or some specific game that they stream will either commission or draw themselves. Generally speaking, it's like an anime looking person, but it doesn't have to be anime. But you basically create some kind of a character art for yourself that represents you. And there's like a whole bunch of ways that you can either... you can have it be static. So for example, you could have just a picture of yourself, or the anime person that represents you, your body. And then it can like light up when you talk. But then if you want to get fancier, then you can do live 2D, which is basically taking a, like a drawing, and then you get people to rig it up though, so that it can track your emotions and stuff. And then like the arms can bend, the mouth can move, the eyes can look around. And it can get actually very sophisticated in terms of expression. It's very impressive what some people are doing with that. And that's live 2D because it's a 2D drawing that they bring to life. I guess Skeffy from Fashionista. I know I saw that she had started streaming. I wasn't able to tune into any of her streams though, so I didn't know whether she was a VTuber or not. But it sounds like Skeffy is a live 2D VTuber, as is Vreeze. And then the third option is that some people do 3D. So they'll actually have a 3D model, which is like, you know, VR chat or honestly, even they could even clip out their 3D model and just have it in the corner. That's, you know, obviously using like a full modeled rendered 3D character that is once again tracking your body and your face especially to be how you communicate with your audience. So that's kind of... VTubing in a nutshell. The VTubing part really specifically refers to just the idea that you are using a virtual avatar in place of yourself to represent you on stream. And then in terms of the like what you actually stream and the content, that's kind of the same as any streamer. I mean, it can be gaming, it can be just chatting, it can be whatever. But a cool thing about VTubing too is that a lot of VTubers end up having like they have like a whole big debut and they have like a whole storyline for themselves, which is pretty neat. They have like a whole lore and background of like who they're like. Let's just say your VTuber model is you know, like a cat girl or something. I mean you know, it could be a Makote, but it could be just like a cat girl from somewhere else. And so a lot of VTubers, the sort of, I would say that the thing that a lot of them do is they come up with like a whole, you know, a lore. It's like a character that they're playing in a way, and it has like a background, like where they're from, what they like and don't like, which might represent what they really like and don't like in real life, or it could be what the character that they're playing is, you know, like. And they have this whole like debut stream, and it's pretty cool. So you can like buy into someone both on their personality as well as the lore or character that they represent themselves as. So anyway, there you go. VTubering kind of in a nutshell. It's a little, might be a little jarring depending who you watch at first. Because like, I mean, if you're not used to that, it can come, it can be a little bit like, oh, I'm not really used to this idea of like the anime, this anime person talking to me. But like, it's something that once you kind of just give it a couple watches, I think, like you kind of get used to it pretty quickly. And it's really cool. It's honestly a really neat, it's like a really neat subculture of streaming. And there's some very, very entertaining people in that realm. But yeah, anyway, okay, so let's get into item reviews. I feel like I almost want to clip the first half hour of this into its own separate thing when I upload it eventually. But okay, so let's like take a look at this, right? So yeah, we have this, we had the bath, I already said. I think it's just really neat. I also like that, I mean, I actually really am a big fan of even the Hingen one. I just think there's a lot that you can do with it, especially when you, you know, you can do stuff like push it into the wall, right? So it doesn't make a lot of sense why there's towels, but like, you know, you could have this here and push the tub into the wall. And then you have this like cool alternative entryway to your house, which I think is pretty awesome when I've when you can do stuff like that. On the flip side, you could hide the whole entryway and only have the tub sticking out somewhere. Very cool as well. Yeah, stuff like this is really neat too, because it's also huge and it takes up a ton of the yard, which you know, obviously everybody knows we have yard yard items are very limited. So the fact that you could take up like basically, okay, the whole, this whole side of the yard is like covered almost by just that one item. Amazing. Okay, and then like the Ivy, this Ivy Bridge? It's a little, like I know it was kind of cool that like some of the other bridges had like you could walk underneath them. And this one is a little, I mean, I guess if you're a Lollafell it works, but that's interesting that this is so low. Like the other ones, they arched a lot higher, but I do think that that's probably, I mean, cool. It's cool that it's like variety. Which makes me wonder, like, I know a lot of people liked to arch it over the wall, and a lot of times, like, this one is kind of low. In this case, I don't, I'm not using walls at all, so that's, it's fine. But I could see how some people who liked doing things like creating alternative paths into their house over the walls might be a little not too pleased that this is so low, because it would definitely clip probably like here, right? But like for in my case, that actually, you know, could work great. It's like just the right height. It needs snow and damage. Oh, Alora, are you talking about this? Right? Like it's too pristine looking. Cause actually, yeah, I do think like that would be something that'd be really cool. I mean, I can't imagine that we'll actually get this, but like it would be really neat if a whole bunch of the items had like toggleable distress states. So you have the pristine version and then you have the like dilapidated or like kind of scuffed up version. Because like we talked about this too with the factory partition, right? Where the factory stuff, it would be really cool if you had the same model for most of those factory things, but they were just clean, like as if they were brand new, but then like still also have access to the rusted version. And you know, just like you toggle on a lantern on and off, it'd be kind of cool if there was like a toggleable, yeah, like a state or something. And same thing with the Ishgard thing, right? Like I know for people who really follow all the lore and stuff, I mean, Ishgard has been at war for like however long. And so it would be understandable that a lot of people would want to build Ishgard builds with a bunch of like burn marks and scratches and You know, like it got hit by rubble or it was a little bit, you know, falling apart versus like super pristine. Although it, I guess you could say that new lore wise, since we just rebuilt the firmament, everything would be pristine because you're building it from scratch, from new. So it does make sense that it's first and foremost pristine, but yeah, you know, having like an alternate distress state would be really neat on a lot of these. And it's a nice low, let's see, and Amphi is referring to, I think, so she, Amphi, you're referring to this with the low dex. Is that like this you're talking about? Oh, I know what you're talking about. Yeah. The deck, right? So if you put the deck up on the wall, it would pop up. And when you have other walls, sometimes like the other bridges are too high, like they're too crazy high. So this is like a nice transition that actually might link up right to the entrance here. Like it gives you a little bit more of a reasonable, like if this was, if you can imagine this deck was lofted up on top of this wall, then this little ramp here would lead right into this a lot cleaner than if it was sloping up really, really rapidly and you'd only be able to use like the corner here or something, right? This would give you much more runway to create like a full sloping effect upward. Hot tubs are saved first, apparently. Oh yeah, talking about like if everything went to shit, you'd have to save your hot tubs first from the dragon rage. What is this? Snowy red brick bench. Oh, I just realized those two, these are all dieable, huh? Or some of these are dieable. This is not dieable, this is. Very cool, look at that. Ooh, that dies quite, ooh, that's nice. I actually really like that. Like this? Like it really makes the green pop. Which, I mean, if you guys have, you know, been following me, then you definitely know that I like me some greenery and popping off from like dark colors and stuff. Although, you know, on the light side, it looks also very nice. Look at that. Ooh, that's also quite nice too. I could really see that being a nice color scheme. Liara! Hey, Liara, what's up? Welcome, welcome. And then let's see, the snowy bench. Again, very pristine looking. Let's see, can you make the brick? Oh, does it not dye the brick? I guess actually it literally says in the name red brick, so it's stuck as red brick, but you can dye the top here. Okay. Well, that's kind of neat. I could see this being a bit niche because it's like snow covered. So, you know, it'd be a little bizarre to have it here, just like standing off by itself. Yeah, I mean, yeah, you can't have everything. I mean, it would be kind of cool to have a bench that looks like this, but without the snow. But again, like, I mean, that's just kind of nitpicking. I mean, I think it's understandable that it comes out with the Ishgard set of stuff and that it looks like that. Oh man, okay, so we, obviously, I think like this kind of speaks for itself, but everybody, I've seen everybody talking about this, right? Right, this gate. And it is super cool, honestly. It's dieable too? Holy heck. What is dieable on it? Oh, the gate itself. The gate is dieable. That's interesting. I feel like it looks a little weird if you get too bright, maybe. It's kind of got to be a neutral thing. Although I could see, you know, like there, like a little tint of green or something could be nice. These look kind of wonky if it gets too bright, but in the dark colors it looks quite nice. I'm always a fan, I'm a big fan of a very naturalistic kind of look, So I would probably, you know, keep it pretty similar to that. But that is really cool. And I like how smooth it is, you know, as it opens. It's just, it's nice, too, that you can move it anywhere. It's not attached to, it's not attached to the wall, which, I mean, I, quite frankly, I, when I first saw this on Twitter, everybody had it here at the entrance, and I thought it was just attached to the wall, the natural walls of the of a house. I figured, like, oh, it's some kind of Ishgard exterior wall. But apparently it's not, which is kind of cool that you could, you know, have like a section here on the side yard, right? Like, I could easily see a lot of people doing this, right? Where you put like this, and then you have this like secret garden that you get come back to, right? Like, how nice is that, right? Oh, you come back here, and then you're just like, oh, you know? It wouldn't be a tree here, maybe, but like, and you'd come back to like their growing, whatever, Thavnarian onions or something back here, right? I think that's really cool that you can put it anywhere you want. I'd love to see more items that kind of get into this kind of thing. Red was nice, pastel pink. Let's see, what is pastel? Was it pastel? Is that pastel pink? There, it's cherry pink? Oh, look at that. Which, okay, this obviously is going to lead into like this. There's like a Candyland thing. This one. I'm going to skip this one for this planter set for a second. Just because since we're looking at the pink stuff, oh my God, this is wild. The instant I saw this, I thought, Donmeg. Or is that right? Donmeg? It's the Fairy Beast Tribe quests. Sorry, semi mini spoiler there. I won't tell you like what happens in that, but like. You know, the fairies in Shadowbringers. Do you guys know what I'm talking about? If you guys have done that, then you probably know what I'm talking about. But like, that instantly reminded me of this. Just like, oh, they just like, this might even exist as this item in that zone. Which I think, if I remember correctly, I think in the patch notes it showed that there was a new exterior wall, which I don't have. I can't show you that, but there's a new exterior wall that's like a big Candyland house. And I saw that, and then I saw that we got this item, and it just was like, oh man, that is 100% Ilmeg Dolmeg. Yeah, I do wonder too, like why Candyland now? Seems a bit like, I mean, that's cool. Like, I mean, I think it's fun. I think this would be great for you know, actually Easter, honestly, coming up, right? Easter events, with just like the bright colors and everything. Is this dyeable? No, it's not. Actually, this would have been kind of cool to be dyeable, to make some of this like switching into like different colored stuff. To make it like extra Christmassy or extra spring Eastery. Maybe extra Halloween, right? Make it like black or like orange or something. But yeah, I do wonder what prompted them to suddenly think like, what can we add during this patch that's all about this new medieval housing zone? Oh, you know what we should add? A bunch of like Candyland stuff. Maybe, to be fair, I have not done, because I was setting up my new stream here and reworking some stuff, I have not actually had a chance to do any of the 6.1 content at all. This is the most I've done of any content related to 6.1. Right now, what we're doing, looking at these items. So I have no idea if Candyland somehow plays into the new raid or the new, I can't imagine the new raid, but I mean, you know, the new MSQ or something. Maybe you go to Candyland. I don't know. Candy Mountain, Charlie. Right? You guys remember that? You remember Candy Mountain? Oh man, I do love this. Weren't they late on the Christmas event? Yeah, I think they've been they're a little behind on a couple events, right? Wasn't Halloween a little late too? Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised if it was like an idea that they just had in the can for a while, like doing Candyland something. Like, it could have been something that they meant to put in when they added like the Pixie Beast Tribes even, right? Or shortly after, but it just wasn't like, it wasn't like a major thing everybody was asking for. So they're like, okay, we can table this. I really like this item though. That's like the Ahriman face, right? Right there. This, let's zoom in. Right here. This is Ahriman vase, pretty much, the leaves. This is like from the potted plant. I think these already exist, like the barreled plants. There's just two of them. And then these flowers, I know, are part of the existing trellis as well, right? If we look at... So we have... So you can remember, like, this is the new one. This is one item. But then if you look at, like, this. There, it's basically this. There's two of these. And then it's the planter box as well. These flowers, right? There you go. See these flowers? Yeah. But really nice. Really nice looking. Whoa. Mouse is freaking out. Sorry. I quite like that. Showing your age, sir. Hey, you guys, if you guys know what I'm talking about, then you're showing your age too, right? Otherwise, you just go, what? What? What's Candy Mountain? Oh, what a classic. Memes before they were called memes, right? I think that's what you'd call those, right? Those early, like, albino black sheep, you know, and Newgrounds or whatever. What was it? Is that... I forget. What was that called? Is that what it was called? There was like a site that was like... had you know, it's like, again, meme websites before meme websites were like a thing. But yeah, let's see. Oh, does this, can this die? No, it cannot die. That makes sense though. Damaged Ishgardian wall. Oh, hey, wait, there's a damp. Zoom out, there we go. Oh wow, that's neat. Whoa, that is actually really cool. I mean, it's probably like semi niche usage, but like, that is really cool if you're building like a castle or something. And I could see how you could stack several of these with each other to make something that feels kind of like a maze, or like, you know, like you really are walking through a bunch of rubble. Especially like if you could combine this with the Garlean crates that we just got, and that would be a really cool, just like a war zone kind of vibe, right? Like you had this down somewhere. I'm sure you could push it out into the walls a bit more, and then you take the these ones, right? Right. You can imagine like how these two could fit together really well, I think. Of course, I mean, if you're a super, super particular on lore, you might say, I don't know why there's a bunch of Garlean crates with a bunch of Ishgard stuff. But in terms of just like literally acting on the like war zone, medieval fantasy kind of thing, I think these could work really interesting together. And I will say up front too, that like when I build, I'm usually not thinking like super specifically Final Fantasy lore. Like in terms of, I'll mash up, okay, like, yeah, I know technically this is the Asm Step stuff and this is the Hingan stuff, and they generally wouldn't probably be like all integrated so much in the same build. But like, I mean, for me, as long as it looks the same aesthetic, that what I'm going for, then that's kind of the main thing. Okay, an Ishgard lamppost. What do we have here? Okay, it's nice, just like a nice lamppost. I mean, simple. Very tall. Right? That's like really tall, I think. Aren't most other lampposts like they stop right about here? I feel like this one's particularly tall, but that makes a lot of sense because of how tall like the walls are. You know, everything, all this stuff. Very cool. I'm kind of surprised that since they gave you like this damaged wall and stuff, a little surprised that they didn't give you like the garden wall, but concrete, right? Like, you know how they have like this? or they have what is it, the, is it a plant? It's like the, this part, the hedge, partitions, right? Like, I'm a little surprised they didn't give us this, but have it be like Ishgardian concrete or something. Yeah, okay, so it's a bit taller than normal. But, I mean, again, it does make kind of sense. Like, I mean, that Ishgard stuff, a lot of, I mean, their whole castle, everything is built very up and tall versus, you know, the, a lot of the Asian stuff is a bit more like lower profile versus like the tall spiking castles and stuff. But yeah, you know what I mean? But do you guys know what I mean? Like, I think I would be really interested to see more, a couple more of these like pieces. And I do wonder if them giving us that gate is an indication that that might actually happen, right? Because this feels a little strange that they gave us a gate that is not attached to a wall, but they didn't give us any walls to use with the gate, and that the gate itself is like really pristine looking. So the most that they added was these new damaged walls, but it would be kind of bizarre to have a really pristine gate next to these extremely damaged walls. So like, I do wonder, right? This feels, it almost feels like this should have a little thing that you can then build out, right? Where you have, it'd be like this, right? Like, you know, maybe, right? And then you'd have, oh, yeah, right? You'd have it like this, right? Where you, maybe you'd walk in or something like that. And then there's like a garden over here, but then, oh, you want to go access the maze or the whatever over here. And then you'd have a wall that connects this and a wall that connects this, right? I don't know. Square Enix, if you watch this video, I feel like that'd be an awesome addition. And it would be probably not too crazy to implement, because it'd just be like reskin the hedge partition and just make it, give it brick texture. Nothing wild, just a simple building block. But yeah, that's okay. That's the outside items. I'm gonna go warp back over to my apartment and we'll take a look at the indoor items. What do you guys think? What do you guys think of the outdoor items? You guys got any favorites, or you know, got the ideas churning in your head on them? The gate and the bridge. Do you have you got any build ideas that you're going for, Liara? If any, the bridge. Yeah, that bridge is very nice. Ooh, hello. Okay. Yay, I made money. And if you randomly, person who bought the zoo horn right now or in this chat, thank you for your money. Thank you for your contribution. Let's see. Oh, here we go. Preview. Okay. We got a whole bunch of items here. We might probably, maybe we'll get through them all. I don't know. We'll see. If we get through them all, great. If not, we can always either pick this up next time or, I don't know, maybe even have like an extra day here. Like maybe could even just like continue this tomorrow or something. Just do like a short, just chatting and just hang out a bit more. Actually, quick question for you guys. Yeah. So I've been thinking about this, you know, because of the way prominence, the scheduling works out for prominence and with my staff members for prominence, right now it's the housing every Wednesday. I do the housing stream, right? But then every other Wednesday I have a prominence opening. So tonight there's prominence nightclubs open. But having the two stacked so close to each other is kind of challenging at times. Would you guys potentially be okay with me moving this housing stream to Thursday, like same time, 4 to 6, but just Thursday? So it's a big Monday and Thursday. Just so that way I'm not always I'm not like double stacking myself on any given day. But I kind of want to just gauge. I mean, I don't want to like lose everybody if like Thursday is a super packed day for everybody, right? And Selena, I know too, like, I mean, we both would want to go to Ichi and stuff, obviously, on Thursday, but this would be, you know, same time, so though, for this would be a housing stream that I'm moving to Thursday, and it'd be 4 to 6, right? So you definitely still have time before Ichi opens at 9, I think it is, on Thursday? Is it 8 or 9? But still, I mean, you'd have, you know, there would be a break there. And obviously housing streams will always be pretty chill, so. The other option would be potentially Tuesday, but I think that the issue with Tuesday is then it's kind of like three back-to-back days with stream, and it's kind of nice to have the Tuesday off so that if I have like prominence or we have, you know, something that needs to be done in between, I have like that kind of day in between to still build out new stuff on that off day. If ever one more Thursday tends to be. But you know, but if Tuesday works way better for everybody, I'm not opposed to Tuesday. It could just mean that like we kind of like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, right? And then we reset. In a way, like having two back-to-back days of housing wouldn't be so bad. Because then if we, for example, right now, right, we might not get through all of these and we would just have like, you know, the next day we could finish anything that we started on Monday. Okay, so Thursday is fire pit nights. Okay, I'm seeing kind of like a split. So how about Tuesday for you guys? Tuesdays would potentially work. Also, I'm gonna start looking here at these housing items. And okay, my first thought when I saw this item was, the books are like very repetitive, but like it looks good. I mean, as a bookshelf, it looks good, but the detail on the side, ooh. So trim, right? Like I'd want to do this. Oops, there we go. And then, there we go, right? Oops, why is it not? Is this tabletop? Oh no, it's a floor. Okay, I saw Sint post about this though. Sint was mentioning there's some weirdness with this item, but yeah, like this, right? Like using this as, that actually looks kind of like a summoning bell. I could easily see this being a really cool placard for, like if you have a fish tank here, right? And then you frame, is this on both sides? Okay, it is. But yeah, if you frame like a fish tank or something like this, right? Then it'd be kind of cool. Like this is a little sign that tells you what's in the fish tank on both sides, right? And then you have one over here and one on the sides. Or even using just this edge, right? As a really little intricate trimming for your pillars or something. If you move this forward, and you can imagine here is maybe like a factory partition or something. And then you'd have this really nice trim that could line it on both sides. If you just put one like one here, and then put one here, and then something in the middle, and you could make custom pillars, right? Okay, Laura's saying Tuesdays are fine. Amphi, Selena, Liara, you know, Ray, whoever else in here. What do you guys think about Tuesdays? If I had to move the stream one day off. Oh, whoa. Factory pillar. Wait. Actually amazing, except it's so rusted. Wait, okay. I guess I shouldn't speak too soon. Maybe do we also get like a clean pillar? Holy heck, wait, because this is amazing. I have wanted something that's a straight up beam. And we got the what was it? The dance pole is a good is the dance pole is fantastic, but it's very thin. So in terms of like supporting like a larger structure, it's kind of weird. But man, this is I've wanted something just like this so long. I just again wish we could toggle on a non-rusted state. Oh man. That'd be so nice. Oh. Or like a wooden beam that's like this. I just want like a clean wooden beam that looks like the Oriental. This one, right? I just want this. Just the beam. I don't even care if it's got the rivets on here, although I'd prefer it doesn't. But like, if it, you know, just you just give me this one beam. But standing alone by itself, not connected to all this stuff, right? That would be incredible. But okay, take with what you get. And I mean, this is a phenomenal building piece. There is so much that people are going to do with this. Except that it's really rusted. I mean, I think the fact that it's so rusted is going to prevent a lot of people from putting it in their builds. But I think, you know, structurally to have be able to do this, right? And then have like an overhang and an overhang. I will probably be making use of this. Because I think this is just... I just really want them to give a clean version of that, though. Again, Square Enix, if you're listening to this down the road. That works. I have a new static on this. There's no locker. Nothing says like deadness. Yeah, tetanus. Oh man, so much rust. But again, I mean, it's a step in. I think it's a great step in the right direction. I mean, I'm a big fan of all the factory stuff. I tend to build stuff that's a bit more clean looking, so it's a little bit tricky. Before I get too far off this, actually, for anybody who starts to build with this thing, Sint, which is Slap Sint, I believe. And Sint is spelled S-Y-N-T. He's on Twitter. He's part of HGXIV. He did a post I saw earlier today where he was describing that this item has some weird stuff where, like, if you're trying to float it, it doesn't want to stick to, like, a wall shelf. And it has, like, some tabletop properties where if you have, like, a table here, right? And you try to take this from your inventory and place it onto the table, it will not allow you to place it. But for some reason, if you place it on the floor first and then place it onto the table, it will actually just jump onto the table and you can just place it down on the table. You just like literally place it down on the ground first though, and then put it up. And then it will just like go up onto the furniture. So if you're interested in building with this, I recommend checking out that post from him because I think he obviously does a better job of explaining and showing it. He has a little video clip. And so that would be very useful for anybody who's going to use this Scholastic bookshelf for your builds. Recommend checking out Sint's post on Twitter. Okay, and then, man, okay, I also saw this. I think the very first two things I saw on Twitter after the patch launch in terms of housing stuff was the outside gate and then this inside one, which looks like it's the same mechanism, right? Like, that looks like the same exact animation, like the easing on it and everything. Except that it swings a little bit wider, but the way it animates and everything, it just feels pretty like, yeah. But this is great. I love it. I think I like that the books are also quite varied. Like, it doesn't feel super repetitive. You know, this, even if some of these are potentially a bit repetitive if you look really closely, but I do like that they did quite a good job of making it feel like there's no obvious repeating pattern here, right? Because that's a big problem I have with the potion rack or the bar, right? This counter is it's very repetitive looking. Like it's very obviously repetitive. Like these two rows are exactly identical. And then same with that new, this one, right? The books are, understandably, it's like encyclopedias or something. So there's like several volumes that are all together. Like, this is more forgivable, to be honest. I mean, because it's Scholastic Bookshelf. These are probably sets of encyclopedia or textbooks, which would come in a set. So it does make sense. But I do really like that. Yeah, this one feels very, you know, different. Also, some friends pointed out this, that if you flip this backwards, it's like a beautiful, perfect wood wall, right? So if you were to hide the bottom here, you would just have this really nice looking wood wall that dyes beautifully. It dyes pretty much like a, whoa, Jesus. It dyes like a, Jesus, if you're still in here, sorry. It dyes like a Hingen, the Hingen furniture, right? It really, really takes the dyes very well. It's like, this is probably exactly the same tone as the Hingen stuff, I think. A new flow for leaning down into a pit. Oh, I see what you're saying, Selena. Yeah, you're talking about like your day-to-day flow of figuring out your schedule and stuff. I gotcha. And this partition, Kevin, are you talking about this partition right now? It's really good, honestly. And if you, again, if you flip this backwards, right? So if you walk into the room, right? Like if you walk into the room and then you have this over here or something, then you could have it be easily like just a really clean wall that opens up too, right? This feels like, so the other way is maybe like a bit like, you know, like a library, right? But then this way feels almost like a spy house. Like I could see someone doing this with, you know, like something more of a modern build and have it be like a trick wall, right? Instead of a trick bookcase. Or if you just, again, if you just hide this bottom part, then you just have this really nice wall. It's just a very nicely built item. I'm curious if we're going to get a 9 out of 10 aspect to this, if someone's already found that or not. But like, honestly, this is a really, really nice item. I really do think this is well done. Like, that's about, at least glancing at it right now, that's pretty much like everything I would have done with it, you know, would want with it, rather. Okay, let's see. What is this? Ooh, interesting. For reference, I've seen a couple things spoil on Twitter, but a lot of these items I'm seeing for the very first time. It's like this one. Is this, hold on, is this a perfect quarter? Yeah, okay, so you could have two of them next to each other. I would hope that if you have two of them next to each other, that they perfectly fit. I see that they're actually NPC purchasable, so we could go buy two of those, but for the sake of time, let's not. But I hope that they, like, okay, let's just, I would assume if you grid snap that it would line up perfectly to that, right? You know, it looks like it would. It should be seamless. I very much hope it is. And it's dyeable, I imagine. There you go. Yeah, very nice. Nicely dyeable. I assume, has anybody used this at all? And can anybody confirm whether the dye options on this dye exactly the same way as the rest of the marble furniture? Because that would be, like, that'd be the big thing of one of those, again, like, what, you know, 9 out of 10 things is if you match this up to the rest of the marble stuff and it doesn't dye the same way. Okay, like, right, or okay, like, just right off the bat, that texture is much smoother, right? This looks very smooth. Okay, and then if you look at the new curved one, it's a little bit textured, which is actually a nicer look, but like, or arguably a nicer look, but I do wonder if that means that when you put these next to each other, if it will cause any issues. Okay, actually, thank goodness these are all okay. Or these are all like looks like the same texture. Anybody tried this out yet? Building with the marble? Whoa. Okay, we'll get to that, I guess, but... So that's very cool. I imagine this is very exciting for people who like that white, pristine, you know, Olympian kind of look or whatever. I'm very curious to see what people will do with that. Partially because to this pushed up will make really cool bar overhangs or something, right? Like if you did this, right? Like, I don't think we've had a lot of really nice clean curves in the game before. So if you put two of these next to each other and then floated up and you had a bar down below here, then you could get like a really cool little counter looking thing, right? Like this would be a really cool corner, maybe like a reception desk or something. Maybe from, and what's the top look like? Yeah, so you could easily maybe push part of this up from the ground in a, well, not in an apartment, but like in a, you know, in a house. Use part of the base, just poking up out of the floor, then float this up. It'd be quite nice, I think. Let's see. Logs. Indoor firewood. Nice. I mean, perfect if you want firewood, but I think... I imagine that most of us are more excited about the metalwork on this thing, right? Because that's the mind of a housing designer, is you look at this kind of thing and you think, okay, yeah, firewood and stuff, but more importantly, design. Like this. Oh. For anybody who builds like, have you guys seen those builds on Twitter and stuff where they make like miniatures for like minions, right? Here you go. There's a door. You're welcome. If you want like, Alora, if you want to build a little like hangout for Fluffy or something like that, and you want a little door, boom, there you go. You put a little doorknob there, right? Like maybe put a little like floor mat or something here just so you can't quite see the little legs here. And bada bing, you got just a little ledge, a little step up, and you got yourself a little tiny door. And then pulls out like one. I mean, yeah, you know, then you can also use this as just like ornamentation for something. Same with here. Let's see what this looks like. Okay. Oh, there we go. Yeah. And you could easily see how you'd interconnect those. Have like, you know, the arch here. You'd either have like a whole bunch of these in a row, or you have the arch here. I know a bunch of people recently have done like dioramas and stuff. And this could make like a really cool fence system. If you put a bunch of them next to each other, I could see that. Yeah, I think there's a lot you could do here. Oh, you actually like, Selena actually likes the firewood more than the metalwork. Fair enough. No, I mean, I agree. It's not my favorite piece of metalwork. And honestly, the firewood is very nice and detailed. Look at that. It's great. Like for, especially with the whole Ishgard and the, you know, cozy cabin thing. Absolutely. Firewood. Really good. I thought I saw a stack of firewood in the preview that looked like it was standing by itself, but maybe I didn't. Maybe it was just this. But still, very cool. If I remember correctly, one of these items is from the submarines, and this might be it. I remember Sint was talking about some item that you couldn't get except for using the FC submarines. It might be this item, but man, this is really neat looking. A little bit niche in its usage because of the Moogles, I think. Because not everybody is going for the Moogle aesthetic. But I think, again, really, really nice. Like, just the the water coming off of this. The pillar here. I could see someone hiding a bunch of this stuff, right? Or like using this as like, let's see, like this. Oh man, look at the design underneath that. Holy. Look at that, right? Like, wow, that's a really nice design. You know me too, right? I mean, I love me some chandelier action, custom ceiling stuff. And that is beautiful. Beautiful texture underneath. It's like they know that we're gonna float it up, right? Because what else, like, there's no reason that needs to be textured underneath. Except if you think that you might put it up here. So good job Square Enix team. I love that, right? They easily could have made that a very bland texture on the bottom to save on, I don't know, texturing or pixels or time or something, but they didn't. Amazing. I love that. Too bad they're probably gonna be from subs. Yeah, Amphi. So I think this is the item that Sint was talking about, where it's from submarines, sub voyages. Hopefully though, it's big enough that you might only need like one or two for whatever you need, you know? Similar to the goober lamp with the little lights on it. What do you call it? This one. Right, this one is also extremely expensive, and I think it's... Well, this is from Maps, I think. Is it Maps or Subs? I forget, but similar to this where, like, a little bit goes a long way with this one, too. Like, I think I have three or four that I use throughout Prominence, but they do work. Like, you can have one per room, and it already does so much. Okay. Oh, more Phasmascapes. Royal Menagerie. Is this where you fight Xenos? Sorry, slight spoiler there. Maybe if you, I'm not gonna say what happens there, but like, I think that's what this is, if memory serves me. If you haven't gotten to Stormblood yet, don't look at my screen. And then Sea of Clouds. Ooh, that's neat. This could be cool. I could see how someone would clip out a lot of this and really just want the trees here, right? Like if you kind of like hide this top part, you could almost get it looking like just like a forest with a bit of fog moving through it. I think that could be really useful. Similarly, you could also just clip out just the top and have it be very much like you're floating in the sky, right? Like castle in the sky kind of thing over here. You know, put your fencing right here. Or this is a nice big block of just big blue sky. If you just want like blue sky, put a window here and then put several of these next to each other. And then like the windows always just show this. And then you could just get a nice, pure, pretty big looking window of blue sky. Actually, I think that would be very useful. I think this is pretty versatile in terms of what this, how you could utilize this. Yes, okay. Selena is confirming. But yeah, I think that'd be really cool. I think there's a lot you could do with this. I actually have not really played around with the Phasmascapes yet, but I like the idea of them. I do wish they would get rid of this, though. Like, the Phasmascapes are, I think, if I had a small nit to pick with Phasmascapes, it's the little metal thing here. Like, what is this supposed to be? I get it's just, like, ornamentation or something, but, like, is there a logical reason that anybody would have this piece of metal? Does anybody, you know? I don't know. When you say yes, do you mean like yes there's a logical reason, or like yes you agree that it's kind of weird that it's here, Alora? Yeah, I mean like framework, like, so I see, like, I understand this, right? Like, I definitely understand, like, this part even, it's a little bit ornate, and I understand that, like, it's boxed in by this, as if it's a TV or it's, like, a whatever. It just... Okay, yes, get rid of it. Yeah, it just seems like... It just seems bizarre that there's these metal pieces in particular, and that they're so ornate, and that they overlap on top of this. If anything, this design, like, should be here, maybe? Or something, right? Or, like, you know, like, frame, like the firewood, right? Or something, it's kind of on the outside, like, framing around it. It's just weird to me that you would overlay, like, this. It literally overlays on top of part of your image, right? Like this. It just seems... I don't know, it just confuses me. Well, what was the thought process of the metal pieces here? Perhaps to keep the skate from moving or falling. Yeah, like, I mean, I could see how, like, it's like, okay, this this piece right here, I could kind of get, right? Like, understandably, this is like, maybe it's like riveting or something. It's kind of affixing your screen or something, right? Like, it's just holding it in place. Like, if you had one here, if you had just this little bit popping in, and it was right here, and then like right here maybe, and on either side, I would understand that more, because then it would be, yeah, like you're holding, you know, like those little hooks that hold a picture in the picture frame, right? But it just, I just don't know why these, like, there's these like little spikes coming out of here, you know? Whatever, okay. It's very workaroundable, right? You just have to hide all of this, but like, I've almost never seen someone just leave these here if they're using this for stuff. Because it just feels a little bizarre. Yulmorin Divan? Is Divan just like a really fancy word for a bench? Is that a rich people's bench? Does anybody know? And it dies, which is nice, because not a big fan of the super bright pink beehive pink. But yeah, boom, get it like there, you know, white or something. That kind of looks like a bed almost. Looks like the mattress, sleep train mattress, or, you know, hey, sleep train, yeah, sponsor me. Doesn't that look, yeah, it looks like a mattress to me. Oh yeah, Liar, yeah, it's totally a Lala-sized bed. 100%, actually, yeah, you're right. Just gotta float something so that you can do a snooze on there. Put a... Someone needs to do this and then put the wine glass. And then do a thing of the Lala jumping on the bed and the wine glass not moving, you know? The true test of the memory foam mattress. Not spilling your red wine. For all those occasions when you are sitting on your bed sipping on red wine and simultaneously your small child or someone is jumping on the bed and you are for some reason just taking it instead of just putting your wine on the, yeah, you know, but you know, it's dyeable, so if they did spill red wine, where's the wine red, right? I mean, is there a wine red? Isn't there a wine? There you go. Problem solved. So then you can say, oh no, it was always red. Or they spilled wine everywhere, and this is the ultimate luxury. This is like vintage, you know, wonderful 87 vintage, blah blah blah, you know, Napa red wine, really good year. The Lenosha winds coming across the sea were very spicy, so the wine is excellent, and I wanted to just live in it, so I spilled it all over my couch. I mean, my mattress. I like wine, okay? You know what? Just, you know, get off my back, right? It can work, right? You can build your lore around stuff. It's maybe a good one. Amphi, are you the one jumping on the bed? Are you that... you that person? Fair enough, I could see it. Did you self-dilapidate that? That sounds kind of bad. But you know, like your fishing shack, which was pristine, and then chaos ensued. That's a neat chair. This is a neat chair. I like this design. I don't really know what I would do with it specifically, but like, oh, it looks like a more glammed up version of the chairs around the knight's table, the round table. Which, if you know prominence, you know I do like that table. They just took off the little lights on the top here. But this is pretty much that same chair. Oh man, I do really like this. I like this design. This is very nice. I don't know what I would do with this specifically, but like I can very much see someone using this as nice decoration. Once again, apart from it also just being a nice chair. But, you know, I don't need to tell you that the chair could be a chair. That's not why you... Actually, I don't know, maybe it is why you come to my stream, for me to, you know, water is wet, kind of thing. But, yeah, look at that. That could be something very cool. That's kind of some zebra-looking vibes, too. I don't know. Interesting, could be cool. Evil lair type chairs. I can see that too. Yeah, this feels like a very like if you built like a vampire castle, right? So that's something I'm very curious to see people try, right? Is like if you did like a, you know, like a vampire castle in Ishgard, because it feels very, because of how cold and stuff is, it feels like you could get some like you know, underworld, right? Like if you guys have watched the series Underworld. A lot of that is like very snowy vampire, but like medieval vampire stuff. And I could totally see using chairs like this in like a vampire court or something. Are these dyeable? Oh, they are. Get a little extra red here. There you are, this one, right? Just that little extra pop of red to give it that extra little like kind of blood vampire look. Like that. Ooh, that is really, that's a really nice, nice red. Upon using that bed for upstairs in a medium. Are you talking about... Oh, this bed. Yeah. This one. So this item, I'm a little torn, I gotta say, about this one. Overall, it's beautiful. Honestly, it's very unique. We don't really have anything that looks... I mean, we have the dome and dogwood, but it's a different look. It's a different look and feel. And there's a lot you could do with this, I'm sure. I'm sure there's already people who are doing a lot of cool things where you... I mean, a lot of people will just hide the bed and use this as an archway or as, like, framing for something. The fact that there's, like, little petals falling is pretty great. I do almost wish, though, that we could have had this archway as an archway instead of attached to a bed. Because... like there, you know, I'd walk right through here, but with the bed, it's a little bit like it clips most people's heads if you were to try to make this an archway. I understand that this was a design contest winner, and I think that they did a really, really good job with this. Like it's very creative, and I love just the way they brought that to life. It is like a one for one almost of what they drew, which is awesome. This one's craftable? I see Liara saying she made it. Made six right away. And yeah, it's true. There's a lot of stuff here we've been looking at that's like, if you're a Lala and you build Lala-sized stuff, then like, this is your stuff. Like, on point. Because this would be a perfect Lala, like, flower archway. Oh man, Liara, if you get married in game and you have a reception, please make like a, you know, like a entryway pathway with just like a whole bunch of these lined up where you guys like walk in through there. I don't know, that'd be just like really cute, even if it's just like a video or something, like of you just like showing up to like your after party and when they do the whole like now announcing the new couple, right? And you guys like come through the thing, like walk through this like flower archway. It'd be very cool. Ah, everything pink, purple, or girly is all you. I see that. I could see that. Yeah, you do seem to very much enjoy the very cutesy aesthetic. Cutesy, you know, girly stuff. And this fits definitely right into that. So when I said I was a bit torn about this, is the only thing that I would say about this is I really like what it is, like, in terms of shape and, like, overall how it's kind of built. Again, minus the bed thing, but, like, for me, the texture feels a little strange. Like, it feels a little bit, like, low texture somehow. I'm not sure. Maybe that's just because of the lighting that I have right now. Like, maybe if this was in lower light, right? Because it's very bright in here. Let me turn the light down a little bit. Like, if it was in a little bit lower light, you had, like, a light on the wall. Do I have a light in here? No, I don't. But yeah, if it was a bit in lower light, I think that, yeah, that could, it doesn't glare off the flowers so much. It just feels a little bit light on the texture compared to the dogwood, right? Like, do you see how, like, how fine detailed, like, that is? Even, like, it feels more, a little more realistic in terms of, like, the texture, the wood texture on the branches as well as on the flowers. I know it's also much more condensed. Like, the flowers themselves are not as big, but I'm a little torn because, I mean, I do think it's a very cute look as it is, but personally, because this is just, again, my personal opinion, but, like, I mean, because I tend to go for a little more realistic look instead of, like, maybe the cartoony Candyland kind of thing, I kind of would have liked to see the texture be a little bit more high fidelity or something on this. This is nitpicking 100%, though. I mean, overall, this is a fantastic item. I'm not trying to poo-poo this. I'm just saying, if I had to, like, you know, give it, this is my thoughts, right? I kind of wouldn't have minded. Somehow, it feels a little something. I wouldn't have minded if it felt a little bit more naturalistic or something. Maybe it's also because, like, you know, like, the way the flowers are, it's like flowers just, like, maybe it's because there's no leaves? I don't know. Because, like, the flowers are kind of just, like, popping out of the wood, right? There's no leaves, though. There's no, like transition. You know, it just kind of, like this flower just... a single flower just, like, spiking up out of this wood, right? And I feel like maybe from a more realistic stance, that feels a little bit strange. But I also understand that... the idea might be that, like, this is an artificial bed created or summoned, right? Like, this feels very like someone built this. It feels like someone, you know, a kid, you know, would have asked for, I want a canopy bed in my room. And so instead of literally growing a canopy bed in real life, you would fabricate this, right? And it does absolutely capture that look. And, you know, that you would attach... you buy some fake flowers and stuff from Michael's and you attach them. But then it's kind of strange that there's like petals falling from the fake flowers, because that's something that would happen with real flowers, right? So, I don't know. You know, again, I'm absolutely nitpicking here. I'm like, you know, but like, I mean, I guess it wouldn't be much of a stream if I just said, okay, cool, look, a flower bed, and that's nice. There's flowers on the bed. You know? But honestly, I'm sure too, this is one of those items where as I get to use it more and as I get to see what other people are using it for, it's going to grow on me more and more and more, because I think that there's probably just so many creative uses you can use for this. You know, push the flowers up to the floor and have a flower garden on the floor, frame a bar, frame your bed, frame all kinds of stuff. It'll be really cool. And oh, you guys already got married in the game 2 years ago, says Liara. Well, a very 2 year belated congrats on that. But yeah, if you guys do get remarried, now you guys got all kinds of new stuff you can build the honeymoon suite for, or you know, your wedding after party with. And wait, can you dye this? Oh my goodness, you can die this. Wait, what can you die? Wait. Oh, just the pillows? That's... Huh. Okay. I guess, I don't know what I expected. I guess it would be kind of like ruin the aesthetic if you were just like dyeing these flowers, but like... Okay, better than nothing. At least you can dye something on it. It's a little limited, but... Again, honestly, overall though, I think it's a great addition. I think we don't have anything quite like this. I think it's a there's a lot that people will do with that. Oh, wow. Well, this is going to be interesting for people who have already built vanity mirrors. It's interesting that it has that kind of glow to it. There's like a little glowing aura around it. Oh yeah, sorry, Selena said, yeah, created or controlled by magic. Yeah, I agree. I think that the bed, that canopy bed, feels like it was grown through magic or something. Or it's like, again, someone's like some very crafty dad or mom's project to bring a flower canopy princess thing into a child's bedroom or something. I think that that's super cool, though. Let's see, and this thing... Yeah, I mean, honestly, I'm trying to think, like, could be... Somehow this reminds me instantly of, like, a Japanese or, like, an Asian coin. You know, the ones where it's, like, the shape that you see with a lucky cat. I don't know why. It just has that shape. But I don't know how you'd utilize that exactly. But it could be interesting. It's the Meowth coin. You know, it's the coin on Meowth's head. So for anybody who very specifically is about to make a diorama of a giant Meowth, boom, you got the coin on his head. You're welcome. And this cabinet. Yeah, kind of cool. I could see how someone would just want this cabinet handle. Like specifically that. Because that's a very nice little handle. And... Well, I guess it might clip with this. Okay, let's... Right, I wonder if you needed a handle, could you do this? Okay, so first of all, great side dresser. You just go... There we go, right? Side dresser in a hallway. That works very nicely. And then also, let's see, if you want just the handle. Let's see if the handle can stick out without all the other stuff. Okay, you might need to work around a little bit of ornamentation here, but overall, you could do it. Like that. And you get your little handle. Feels a little bit like, is it the pot of cream stew maybe has that handle already? But, you know, just potential thought there. Let's see. What is this? Whoa! And is this what I think it is? Swing open. Ooh! Oh, that's cool. Ooh, I like this. Look at the texture on that stonework. That's really nice. I wonder if there are more items that match with this down below, but that's really nice. Actually, I really like this. Look at the detail on this. It's very nicely textured. If you zoom in, it's a little bit low here, but like, overall, yeah, I really like that. And a little swinging door action thing again that we've seen with the gate and everything. Because this was a big problem that I had with the other counters we have, right? Is that the gate doesn't open, right? Again, I understand why that would be like back when they first made it, but this stuff, right? this is like, this is clearly where the bartender would walk through here, right? This would, this should be able to pop open, but there's no switch to either manually open this or have it automatically open. And that always kind of stumped me when I was building venues and stuff, right? Because same thing here, right? This should, it even has the little like hinges where it would swing open and you'd walk through. So for example, if you did this in the corner, right? I mean, this is a very natural thing that you would do. Then you'd have your person standing right here. But they just, because we, like in my case, at least, I'm building for a lot of times venues where they would actually staff a real person and put them here, right? Not just an NPC. It just kind of always was like, dang, I wish there was an option to have this open so that the person who's role-playing doesn't have to jump over this or ghost through it to get back to the bar. Especially if it's an active bar and there's an actual, like, you know, thing, and the bartender would grab the drink and come out to the table to serve someone and have to go back into the bar. This always posed the problem to me. So, you know, you'd end up doing like this or something and just have like a second one of these maybe, and then just have like an actual gap here. But then, you know, it just seems like, you know, you'd want to make use of this. So I love that this new counter actually allows for that. Where is it? There it is, right? This is perfect for that tavern look. And you do this, and then you'd have your bar counter here, and then your bartender can actually come here and walk through, grab their drinks, and then walk back out. Let's see what this looks like underneath too. I realized I didn't look at the underneath of a lot of these things. Okay, nice texture though. I'm not sure exactly what people will use that for, but like, I mean, it's nice that it's also textured nicely on the bottom. And I just really am impressed with the way they textured the stone. The stonework on this is just really nice looking. It doesn't really match with any of the other stonework, which is my only concern there is, yeah, that like, the other like really nice stonework is the masonwork stuff. And this stone is distinctly very different. Let's see, it's dyeable. Okay, the wood is dyeable, which makes sense. But a lot of people right now, right, when they build with stonework, they build with the masonwork stoves and stuff. So what is it? Hold on. It's this, right? So they take this, right? A lot of people, when they do castle stuff, they go like this, right? But this is a very different character of stone than we just saw there. This is, you know, darker. And the other one is very white and bright. And so if you were to try to connect this up, it would feel a little disjointed. And so I am curious if they're going to give us more... Similar to how I said it with the gate outside, right? The gate, the exterior gate. It feels like naturally they should now give us like a counter that's like this. And again, maybe they do have it here. I just haven't gotten to it yet. I don't know. But Selena says part of the reason she went, oh yeah, so part of the reason you designed your apartment was because how you wanted the Riviera stuff. Makes sense. Is there any Riviera stuff you could look up to see? That's a good question. I don't really know. Let's look at the Riviera stuff quickly. No, I don't recall. See, the thing is, I don't recall Riviera having a lot of stonework on the interior stuff, right? Like the exterior has a lot of stone, white stone, but most of it is like wood and metal, right? So this is the new thing. It's this particular type of stone, too. It's just so specific looking. It's beautiful. I want more of it. But it's this, see, wood and metal. It's all like very much, this is like stuff on a pirate ship, right? Wood and metal. Just straight wood, lantern, flower pot. The rugs, yeah, see, there's not really any, like even on these, right? It's all wood. That's all just like straight wood. there's not really a lot of stonework. This is the closest thing, right? Which almost makes me feel like maybe this is what they wanted originally. They would want like a stone texture here, stonework. Was about the door, wanting a little door, but none move. Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah. Little door. Yeah, exactly. I think so many of the items in this patch are a really good step in the right direction, though. Like this, I think I totally understand if this is just them kind of getting a feel for people like this stuff. And then they'll say like, oh yeah, now we can take this texture and we can make a bunch of other items that, you know, in future patches that would have this, because that would make a lot of sense. Because right now this item doesn't match with any other item that I'm aware of in the game. But, you know, even just a simple wall would be perfect for this. Oh wait, you're saying this counter goes with a stone trim? That's interesting if this, I know Liara has a apartment. Also, I didn't see your comment earlier. Amphi, were you saying your favorite piece this patch? Is it this one? Is it this the gate? Or are you talking about the dresser? But yeah, if anybody can confirm, so this matches the Ishgard interior walls of the apartments and houses. I know there's like a stonework on the base of Ishgard apartments and stuff. But it's strange then that they wouldn't call this Ishgard swinging counter, right? Like, why call it Riviera if it matches with the Ishgard stuff more? Again, kind of nitpicking though. I mean, it's honestly a really fantastic item. I just want to see more of it. Okay. On primal alt now, trying to get pixie glam. Pixie glam for like something is particular, or like, are you going to an event, or you just felt like making a pixie thing? And yet, okay. Amphi, I'm curious. So, what do you have things in vision for this? You're saying this is your favorite item this patch. What do you what are your thoughts on it? And it'll be a theme when I create my website design. Okay. Hey, I look forward to seeing your website design if you're willing to share, of course, Liara. That's cute. Pixie themed website and character vibe. I like it. And it suits you. Amphi saying they were requested, their FC wants a tavern. That's right. You did mention that a rowdy adventurer tavern, right? I totally see it. 100%. Adventure Hall. Perfect vibe with this. And again, like, if it's an FC bar, then absolutely people would probably be bartending or like role playing with that and kind of running around. And so it's great that they actually can go in and out of their bar area. Can't wait to see it, Amphi. Please do share once you have completed it. And then, okay, here we go. This cathedral lectern. Oh, interesting. I like this. I like this a lot, actually. You know, and it says a lectern, like, as if, someone from the Knights or something would come up and give a speech up here. But honestly, when I see this, I see it as a reception desk or like a, you know, a attendant near the door. Like you walk up to, like when you're walking up to a guild hall, right? Or something like that. Like you walk in the front door and there's a receptionist, right? She's like standing here. It's like, welcome to the adventurer hall. On this side, you know, you'll find the marketplace. This side is a restaurant. And up top is the sleeping quarters or something like that, right? Like, so less like giving a lecture and more like a greeter stand. That's what I see here. And let's see, Amphi says, I need the level 60 crafter gear for it, which is only attainable from the hunt person in... Oh, no, sorry, this is Liara saying this. If anyone here is on Prime, what can help maybe Liara out there, then? Oh, wait, never mind. You're saying you need to dress your character up as the level 60 gear. I see what you're saying. Well, maybe someone can help you do a little bit of that. Mediums are scary. Amphi, is this the first time you're building in a medium? Which is exciting, but I agree. It is kind of scary when you suddenly have so many extra slots and you're also building, like, in your case, for your FC or something. So it's kind of like, whoa, pressure. But I'm sure it's going to come out amazing. You can always throw it into work in progress in the Discord and get people's thoughts and stuff if you need some extra opinions. Yeah, lectern, not lantern. Lectern. And I don't know the technical definition of a lectern, but I do believe that it refers to, yeah, like, you know, when you go to church or something and there's the stand where the priest, you know, comes and gives his sermon. I believe that's usually what it kind of refers to, as well as people giving speeches, just like when you go to conferences or something, right? And there's like this little stand where they put their notes and stuff. That's the lectern. It's not a word that comes up very often, unless you are someone who gives speeches a lot or goes to conferences a lot and puts them, even if you went to conferences a lot, I don't know that you would necessarily know the term lectern, because it's not something that you would need to refer to. You'd probably just say the podium or the stand, or just say like, oh yeah, the presenter booth or something, right? Never mind, the stone counter doesn't match the Ishgard apartment. That's fine. I mean, I'm honestly... I have a strong bet that, like, they're giving us a bunch of these items to kind of get a feel for whether people are interested in that kind of thing. And that they will build out more. Because, again, it just seems bizarre that you would introduce something like, this is a Riviera counter in a patch that's so dedicated to Ishgard, and then give you nothing else related to that. It just seems like... random, right? So I would imagine that the more stuff will come on its way soon. But yeah, I really like this. Let's see what does it look like underneath. Is it pretty basic on the texture? Okay, you know, it's nothing particularly special. I do like that there's it's maybe a little hard to see right now, but there's a little metal trim that runs, there you go, see? There's a little metal trim that runs along the edge of this. And so I could see someone making a custom ceiling where they tile a whole bunch of these next to each other, and it makes for a really nice clean, but with a little touch of metal plating on the ceiling. And you could like run some beams in between, maybe if you want to give it extra support or something. But I could easily see this making a very nice ceiling because of how clean it is. And because it has that little bit of framework, so it does distinguish itself from, say, the floor mats, because the floor mats just gives you a super duper clean, like, you know, flat ceiling. But I like that this almost feels like, you know, when you go into office buildings and stuff and you look at the ceiling, how it's like panels, right? I think that that's kind of what I get from this. It's like got that little bit of a paneled look. Does it dye too? Can you dye this? You can dye this. Okay. How does this dye? Let's give it something really light. I like this, right? So if it's like this, that's kind of cool. If you, again, like if you're going for like this, like some of the reds could be neat here. Very dramatic looking. Same with the blues, right? Something very popping. Yeah, like this. I don't know. Does it die underneath though? No, it does not. Okay, so it'd be a little specific on what you can use it for roof-wise, but this might be something that I make use of, is like that paneled roof look, because I really like surfaces that can be used like that. Trying to get a large FC house, but I never directed one that big. I'm excited and terrified. Yeah, I know what you mean, Liara. I went from my apartment to I got a small in Shiragane, But then before, like, I think, yeah, and then I built my small into a Japanese temple, which was already like quite challenging. It was really fun, but it was like really challenging. And then I had the honor of building Ichi nightclub for Roth shortly after that, actually, shortly after I finished that. So I went straight from a small right into building a full on large and building like a nightclub, like an RP venue. And everything else I had built so far was not really like a full on RP venue. And so that was quite a challenge, but it's great. If you've never built in a large before, it really offers so much possibility, especially because you, like, the bottom floor is so huge if you want to build something really long and narrow. And then you have that gigantic cavity when you first walk into the house, like above the stairs, which is like how prominence is done. It really opens a lot of doors to creativity, giving you that big void of space to build in. Not the literal void, but the, you know, the empty space in the house. Really cool. I hope you guys are able to get one. I hope all of you guys are able to get whatever houses you guys are going for, because I'm really excited to see what... I'm sure you guys have tons of ideas, and I'm curious to see what you do with that. Oh, whoa, that's... There's like a reflection or something, right? It's like shiny in this one. That's cool. Whoa, actually, and it's like hollow. Ooh, I really like this. This is really cool. That's not something we've really seen much before. This, like, it's a very subtle detail, and it's probably not going to be what everybody wants, but like the fact that this is see-through, this feels, I was going to say this looks almost exactly like the Riviera table, right? It's very similar to, or the walnut table. There it is. It's like walnut table or, is it the Riviera table? I don't know. There's another table, I think, that looks very similar to, yeah, you know, it's pretty much like this, right? Riviera table. Late dining table. Yeah, anyway, this scholastic table. It's very nice, though. I really like, it's very, I like that it's got that little bit of a polish, a shine on it. It's kind of cool. They did a good job with the texture too, giving it a bit of it's like a brushed stonework or brushed metal look instead of just like super pristine. It's got a little bit of a brushed look to it. Very nice. Okay, I don't have too much to say about that one. Dies. All right, dies very well, just like the other ones. And I like that it seems like they're standardizing a bit more of the color of the dye. I think that they probably heard the people, you know. It's kind of frustrating when it's like, I try to dye everything bone white, but it's all different colors. So I like that this feels pretty close to the Hingen, the way the Hingen one dyes when you dye it bone white. So I like that we're getting sort of a consistency in terms of the way color interacts with the items. And let's see, I know we're running a bit short on time here, so question, would you guys want to, I'm definitely not gonna be able to get through these items all today. Do you guys want to do like an extra stream tomorrow, maybe, to just kind of go through the rest of these items and just have like a, you know, just chatting, and maybe it's like a go through the rest of these items and have just a bit of a just chatting stream or something? So I should also preface this by saying, or not preface this, but in addition, I should let you guys know. So I will actually not be able to stream next week. So this is one of the reasons why I'm saying like, oh, maybe we should get through these items this week too. Partially because we didn't have a stream on Monday, but also because next week I actually will not be able to stream. I have some IRL engagements that I need to go to, and actually that'll be the case 3 weeks from now as well, like the very first week in May. So all good things, like it's not nothing to be worried about or anything, but it just it's stuff that I had that had been arranged and planned many, many months ago, and it kind of kept getting pushed back and stuff because of COVID and things. So unfortunately, they're all kind of unfolding right now, so I'm going to be missing some streams in the next couple weeks or so. And so, yeah, I kind of want to just get a feel for what you guys were thinking. An empty library of what we first started. Yeah, so, okay, Liara's saying for sure. And of course, like, as always, you know, I'll record the VOD of all of these, too. So, I mean, if you can't make it tomorrow, then you can always catch it later. I think we'll do that. I think maybe tomorrow from 4 to 6. So the same time frame that we always do, right? But I'll try tomorrow from 4 to 6. Let's finish up looking at these items. And then next week, I will be gone, so I will not be able to stream. I'll be around, but like I just won't be able to stream, unfortunately. So I'll still talk to you guys in Discord and stuff. Then the 25th we'll be back with the normal, you know, Monday, Wednesday and stuff. I'll have to think about whether we move it to the Wednesday to a different day or not already or whatnot. But yeah, let's do that. I would also just go over, but this is the thing, right? We have prominence coming up in 2 hours. So I need to go eat some food and then also set up some more stuff for that. So I don't want to run over too much time right now. Otherwise, I would just finish out the items right now. But yeah, so for anybody here who's on the stream, tell your friends and everything. Two things. One is we will finish up looking at these new 6.1 items tomorrow from 4 to 6. For anybody who's free. And then tonight, in 2 hours, from 8 to 10 p.m., so before the maintenance, I know there's a scheduled maintenance tonight, but before the maintenance tonight, we're going to have Prominence nightclub opening. And for anybody who does not know, let's see here. This is the address of Prominence. It's a nightclub that I built for anybody who is here in the stream and is not aware. This is a nightclub that I built myself. And that I will be DJing at tonight as well. So owned, operated, run, DJed by myself tonight. And I guess I own the club. So yeah, for the foreseeable future. In case you've never seen Prominence and you don't want it spoiled, look away for a moment. I'm going to quickly show a little teaser of it for anybody who is not aware. This is right below the gameplay footage right now. I have the address. I'll switch back to this in a moment. But for anybody who's not aware. Okay, spoiler warning, it's going. So 3, 2, 1, here we go. So for anybody who's never seen it, this is a little snapshot, a little teaser sneak peek of the nightclub. So we're gonna be open tonight from 8 to 10 p.m. PST, which is 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. EST. So if you like electronic music or just want to come hang out and vibe out, 100% too, you can always just tune into the stream and let it be your iTunes as you do the Alliance raids and PvP tonight. So would love to have you out. And yeah, it'll be a lot of fun. Even if you've never gone out to a nightclub in Final Fantasy before, no pressure, but like, come check it out. It's a lot of fun. Even for people who are new to the whole scene and stuff, it's very accessible, very approachable. There's a lot of just really nice people coming out and enjoying some music together and hanging out. We got a little mini game going on there too. It's a lot of fun. It's a really good time. I highly encourage you to come and bring your friends. If you know anybody, tell your FCs, help me spread the word. Because I'd love to just have you guys there to hang out. I just love sharing music with everybody and seeing everybody hanging out and partying. So yeah, tell your friends, come out to Prominence. If you're in my Discord, I'll post more information in the Discord. I'm also going to post ads on several of the major other Discords that I'm a part of. But a lot of it is like word of mouth. I'm not in like a million billion Discords, and I don't want to join them only to just advertise. Help me spread the word. Tell your friends. Tell your FCs. You can take a screenshot of this if you want, and come out. Yeah, I'm gonna switch back to gameplay chat now. Okay, here we go. So yeah, come out to that tonight, 8 to 10 p.m. PST. Yeah, 8 to 10 p.m. PST. Come check it out. Would love to have you there. And tomorrow we will pick up where we left off here with these items. So with the steel locker, and we will go from. Oh, airplane coming by. But yeah, we will pick up here tomorrow where we left off. Looking at these 6.1 items. Thank you guys for coming. I unfortunately gotta run and get some food and prepare for the nightclub, the DJ set tonight. But this was a lot of fun. It's really nice to talk to you guys all again. I missed you guys on Monday. It was a good time for me to work on the stream, so hopefully it was much more watchable today. It was much more smooth as I was running around here. So thanks for bearing with me, and I hope you guys are enjoying 6.1. I look forward to doing some of the content myself, as I have not actually had a chance to do any of the content myself yet. So hopefully in the coming days or so, I'll get a chance to do some of that. But yeah, for any of you guys doing 6.1, enjoy the new content, enjoy the new items. I will see you guys hopefully tonight at Prominence 8 to 10 PST at the address there below the gameplay. And if not, hopefully see you tomorrow for an impromptu finish up stream, 4 to 6 p.m. PST. And if none of those things, then I will see you hopefully on the 25th when I'm back. And I'm able to stream again, housing, Monday housing stream. So, yeah. Thank you guys so much for coming though to this housing stream. I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you had fun. Hope you learned some stuff, got inspired. And I will catch you guys later tonight, tomorrow, or the 25th. Thank you. And as always, the VOD will go up pretty much right after this is done. So if you guys want to review the VOD, it'll be here on my Twitch stream. And I'm still working on getting my YouTube channel stuff set up. But yeah, if you guys want to review the VOD or show your friends, all the VODs from all the housing streams are up here on my Twitch channel. So you can enjoy those. And yeah. Until next time, take care. Bye-bye.